I have to do this before they find me. Okay. Where do they start? At the very beginning, I guess. Almost 10 years ago, one of my friends gifted me a copy of Slaptasis Agentas 0080 for my birthday. I honestly thought it was a Lithuanian game because it was in Lithuanian, and we basically never get localizations of decent games in Lithuania. And also, it was the single worst video game I had played in my entire life, and it might have put me in danger right now. I'll explain later. Why was it so bad? Well, I booted a game with my friends and none of us could even get past the first level. Slaptasis Agentas 0080 was an action stealth game with horrible everything. And it would not even let you get seen by anyone. If you get seen, it's game over. A lot of the times you don't even see the NPC that spots you, and it's incredibly frustrating.
Oh no!
Oh shit!
After my birthday party ended, I never played the game again. Hell, I even threw out that devil's CD. I was deliberately looking for bad games to laugh at, and I remembered that horrible game I played in my childhood. I did not have the CD anymore, so I had to find the game online. And it wasn't easy. The Lithuanian version was nowhere to be found. The Lithuanian version. I figured out it wasn't a Lithuanian game after all. It had a proper English release called Super Agent 008. It also had a Russian version of the same name, but both of these were just localizations too, and the original was something else completely. The game was made in Poland, that's not too far from Lithuania, and it was called Detective Rutkowski is Back. Now that's a big change. Anyway, I sacrificed my sanity to complete the game. I have no evidence that anyone else did such a feat before. So after numerous attempts, I finally got past level 1.
Yes!
History is being made right here.
There are 10 levels in total. Each of them also has a bonus objective that only gives you a star in the main menu if you complete them. They're completely useless. Hello.
I love how he's just pointing his rifle at nothing.
Alright. Level 2. I could not believe it, but it was even harder than level 1. Not only I couldn't be detected by anyone, I also couldn't shoot anyone. That was absolutely mental. Eventually, I got past that level too. Level 3 was a lot larger and even more difficult. I had to go around a city undetected, not being able to shoot anyone, and I had to knock out several Gopnik drug dealers. They were different from all the regular Gopniks because they wore red tracksuits. But figuring out how to do it was still time and sanity consuming, because the game never teaches the player that it's even possible to knock someone out. It doesn't have any tutorial or tooltips at all. And man, knocking dudes out in level 2 would have been so handy. I did get past the hellish third level, but I couldn't even imagine that level 4 would be even harder.
Yeah, man, I did it!
There were more enemies. I couldn't get seen as always. I couldn't shoot. I couldn't even knock anyone out. That was the breaking point. I was ready to give up. The only way I could get through the game was by cheating. But there are no known cheats to such an obscure game. Yet, for the first time in my life, I found the cheats myself. I just had to find a TXT file in the game's documents and change some zeros to ones to unlock the rest of the levels.
I think it worked, man!
Honestly, I'm glad I did cheat and did not stop playing the game completely. There's one thing that kept me going. You see, back in the day when buying game CDs was still a big thing, people would check the screenshots on the back of the CD case instead of reading reviews online, and there was a screenshot of Agent 008 shooting an assault rifle at bandits on the back of Flaptus's Agentus Nullis Nullis or Shiny case. I expected to see that stuff right from the level 1, and was greatly disappointed that I couldn't even kill or get noticed by enemies. Even if I could kill people in some levels, I couldn't just shoot them if they've seen me. That was ridiculous. But yeah, I wanted to see Agent 008 shoot some bandits real bad. And eventually, the game came to that. And it's more glorious than I could ever imagine. I'll let the footage talk for itself.
Multiple guns, lots of bullets,
oh,
allies, holy shit, and a floating, whatever this is.
Ammo.
Let's go, man. That music.
Holy shit, the music comes fast. That fucking airsoft.
I don't even have a reload animation. I'm stuck. This guy is squeezing me against the wall. I cannot shoot him. This guy doesn't give a fuck.
This game is so bad, man. Oh wow!
Oh, not Vasya!
What the fuck is happening?
Someone is trying to shoot me. I think I see his leg.
Yeah. Does he knock one out of ammo? What the fuck?
Oh, there's a radioactive barrel. Shooting it does nothing.
Do you think Gopniks are scared of radiation?
Okay, shot the guy. What is going on? Oh. That guy had wonderful aim.
He was shooting at the box in front of him. For fuck's sake. You're gonna die from a beat in the distance again. It's happening again.
Yeah, the animations are ridiculous, AI is barely existent, sounds not believable, and so on. But plot thickened after I completed the game. It still bothered me that the name of the Polish version of the game was so different from other ones. It wasn't knockoff of James Bond originally, and the color of the game was slightly different too. It had a photograph of a real person instead of just made up cartoon character. So I googled who the hell is this Rutkowski guy, and he turned out to be a real person. But it didn't feel like he was a real person. I mean, look at his haircut. Anyway, I managed to gather some information, and it turns out he's an actual detective. And on top of that, he was, I think, in Polish Sejm. Since I know many tongues, I figured out what same is without Google Translate. It's the parliament. Who even voted for him? Was the game a part of his political campaign? In any case, I don't think he's doing a good job as a detective if he becomes a celebrity. He's supposed to be a secret agent or whatever. And you know what? The dude even has his own website called Rutkovsky Patrol. What a name. And it is an actual thing, this Rutkovsky Patrol. There are videos of it on YouTube. But I must say, they are super strange. One of them is just Rutkovsky walking in some nightclub, not saying anything, for 16 minutes. What is the purpose of such video? Is there some secret message? Does the steps translate into Morse code? There are also videos of him singing. Better not watch those. Also, I had a good laugh seeing generic orange soda vending machines in level 2.
Orange.
I'm guessing they sponsored this game.
But know what? These are a real thing. In fact, I have drank this orange soda. Is Rutkovsky Patrol aware that I'm actively investigating them, trying to uncover their sinister schemes of world domination? Are they trying to poison people with that drink? Are they trying to drive people insane with that game? Whatever the case is, I'm aside now. I think I'm being watched.